Whether you're sold on some good old Costa del Sol,
Dumpty and Dandria,
or maybe you're partial to a bit of Costa Blanca.
I love Benidorm. It's cheap, it's cheerful.
There's one thing us Brits all agree on. Take it away, ladies.
Spanish sun is always fun.
It's why many of us say bye-bye, Blighty, and hola, sunny Spain.
Viva la España.
Sí, sí, Karen. Living that life in the sun can come with a cost.
It is difficult when you work together, you live together, you've got kids together.
It can be a tough grind.
We're making it work as best we can.
But when the working day is done...
€244.
You might just make that fantasy a reality.
We love the current bun in Benidorm.
Loving it here. Love every minute of it.
Absolutely love the place.
And that's why there will always be...
peace around the world.
Cheap and cheerful.
Very hot, very nice.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Today on the Costas, saleswoman Jojo gets stuck in with her new job, flogging homes on wheels.
Ready for a bit more park life.
It's date night for husbands Will and Steve.
Ready for action.
Ready for salsa.
And a horse in trouble means a call to animal rescuer Colin. It's the crack of dawn on the Costa Blanca. And born and bred baker, Londoner Lee Baldwin is already up and about.
So it's been about 4 o'clock. We've missed the start of the market and then we're Willem's straight. And obviously I'm making it on my own, so I need to get my finger out.
Lee bakes alone on a Sunday. This busy baker's day starts in the wee small hours.
So my family have now got used to me disappearing on a Sunday morning, getting up for the market, where before I used to have a day off, but not no more, so they hope.
Running a bakery and shop in the small village of Rajales is hands-on.
We're going to start making the bread straight away.
But getting his hands on the ingredients isn't as easy as it looks.
In England, you can pick up the phone and get flour like that. Here, no way. You have to research. It depends on price as well.
There's a procedure what we do. So come in, switch the ovens on, switch prover on. Prover is where obviously the main bread gets proved. Without this, the bread would dry.
Dough isn't the only thing Lee has had to prove since moving here 3 years ago.
Coming to Spain is definitely hard. And having your own business is, it's not easy.
Even the 40 years I've been in the trade, I've learned so much about in bakery in general.
If Lee can bring in €300 today at the market, he'll cover his costs and go into profit, topping up his earnings from the shop.
If I don't hurry up, I'm not going to make the market for 8 o'clock.
All his bread is baked fresh each morning.
So I'm making the tiger paste. We have to let it ferment for a little bit before we use it. It has to be a consistency where it's wet.
He's got just 4 hours to produce 150 loaves, rolls and baguettes to sell on his stall, alongside his pies and cakes.
The thing is, if I'm on my own and I'm baking, I'm in my element. I get into a mode where I just go.
Everything here is done by hand, so you have to hand scale, then mould.
Lee knows by sight and hand how much dough he needs with 40 years in the baking trade.
I'd always worked for someone in England. See, I wanted to own my own business. I didn't want to be an employee in Spain. So the opportunity came up to open up my own business, which I've always wanted to do.
You must always fold the bread when you're making. If you didn't knock out the gas, you didn't fold the bread, you'd get a big hole right through the centre of the bread.
The bagel, then?
The tiger face, it's a flavouring, really. As the bread proves up, it goes, sips into the bread, and then it gives it more flavour. So it gives it, like, a crisp.
Ooh, sounds tasty. Lee's also trying a home favourite at the market today.
Poppy seed is popular in England, so we're going to try this today to see if they sell. Hopefully.
It's hard work, but grafting like this keeps Lee in his new home in the sun.
For some reason, in my head, I've always thought I wouldn't have moved to Spain, regardless of the business or not. And here I am. I've got to make the next dough before that's ready.
Get cracking, Lee. You need that bread to rise to the occasion. As the sun rises over the Costa del Sol and its capital, the seaside city of Malaga, there's a warm welcome from a face that might just be familiar.
Since you last saw me, I've inherited another cat, Pussycat, so now I have two. So I have Pootie and Smokey.
And Cockney native Jojo Love has recently made another change in her household.
I live downstairs as an apartment. I'm not living here alone anymore.
Ayo, really?
No, I haven't got a boyfriend. No, I have my best friend, Robert. He's come to stay. He's taken over the top floor. And he's a chef, so I'll get all my food cooked for me. What more can I ask for? What more can a girl want?
Well, he can do the washing up as well, Jojo.
Follow me. Something new up here.
Right, let's find Rob the lodger then.
So this is Rob, my mate. You saw him last time buying bacon off me and sausages. Yeah, well, now he lives here. There you go. This is his living room. You like living with me, didn't you?
It's not too bad at all.
And living with Jojo means there's never a dull moment.
Loud.
Am I loud?
Yes.
No, I'm not.
I think she has a TV very loud.
Rob is, like, top guy. Retired. Came to Spain. Great. Cooks for me every night. All these pots and pans get well used. Not by me. And I still don't wash up. He bought his dishwasher.
Sounds like a good deal to me.
I've been in Spain for 2 years now. My life's changed so much. And I've just sort of, like, settled down now. I feel like this is home.
Jojo hasn't just got a new lodger, she has a new job too.
I've always been a salesperson, but I got a phone call 8 weeks ago, and next thing I know, I'm selling caravans, I'm selling homes in the sun.
She can't be static. Jojo's got a long list of clients who need help with their caravans.
Today I'm meeting a couple, Joe and Steve, and they are looking to sell their caravan. I've also got another couple that want to sell. They've left me the keys, so I'll go in and do a video of theirs and take some pictures. First 3 weeks, I've sold 7 caravans. I've sold people 7 dreams so far.
You've set yourself a precedent now, Jojo. You've got a busy day ahead.
I have got bags of energy, and it seems to rub off on the clients. The Jojo experience.
Coming up, it's a visit to Sparkle Town with Will and Steve.
I do have lots of clothes, gowns for the evening shows. I have them in various places.
And animal rescuer Colin is G'ing himself up for a four-legged mission.
I just don't know what to expect when I go and look at the tortoise at there.
Back in Rojales, Lee Baldwin's got an oven full of bread ready to be sold at the Sunday market.
The pressure's on to get it all together. I can't afford to any muck-ups.
He's been at it since before dawn.
These sell for 70 cents a roll. We have done. It's a no-brainer. The market, for me, is definitely the way to go forward.
It opens in just 2 hours, so he can't be late. He's got a crust to earn.
Obviously, the shop's got a lot more overheads. The market has just the rent, but the electricity is shared in the market among all the people who are on the market, so it's quite low. I wish it was as low that for my shop because it's astronomical.
Energy bills are no laughing matter, even in the sun. But if Lee can make 300 euros at the stall today, he'll be more than happy.
There's 12 batteries, eh? Done. We have done. For me, speed is the key.
Before we opened, we looked at our business plan and we was gonna target bars and restaurants for wholesale.
They're ready.
COVID happened, bars and restaurants struggled. It was really hard for them as well as me. As we've started to pick up, but there's not enough for Baldwin's to survive on just wholesale. So I need to have a look at the business plan again. If I can get in the market, I can try it to see if it'll work.
They are cooking quick.
Lee's launching his poppy seed loaf at the market today.
Every week's going to be different. I'm prepared for that. So you've got to be cautious in what you make and all.
Good thinking, Lee. You don't want stock you can't flog. No one likes a stale bloomer.
That's the tiger paste. It has the tiger look. They're the plain bloomers. So a good bloomer is a crusty bloomer like that. When you do that on the bottom, you know it's crusty. It's got an aroma. You can smell it though. Guarantee you they'll fly out in the market. Then they'll be gone. Boom.
I wish it was Smell-O-Vision. Lee's loaves aren't the only thing that's risen this morning.
Here we go, look at them.
So has the sun, and it's time for business. With 150 perfectly baked baguettes, loaves and rolls, it's time to get them sold at the Guardamar del Segura market.
Vital. The best ever.
Oi, use your loaf. Stop eating your profits.
When you own your own business, you have to drive it. If you do not drive it every day, if you become unmotivated, it's not for you.
We are ready to rumble in the market. Let's go.
There are some Brits who are experiencing their first time in España.
I thought it was a bit cliché, but it's so much better than I thought it was going to be.
This is my first time in Benidorm. It was on my bucket list.
First time being in Fuengirola, I absolutely love it.
Then there are the diehards.
I've been here 42 times. I'm not quite sure if I like it yet, so I'll keep coming back.
Maybe you'll decide on your 43rd holiday, Colin. Then there are those who decide never to return to the blighty shores and make the firm decision to make Spain their home. Like East End native...
Morning! How are you?
Jojo Love.
Did you get your bargain in the sun?
Did. Late morning on the campsite in the popular resort town of Torre del Mar, newly appointed caravan saleswoman Jojo Love is hard at work.
Hello, darling, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks to you.
She's been here 17 years and she loves it, don't you?
I certainly do. Love you.
Thank you, love you too. I'll see you later.
Jojo knows everyone here.
What really makes this game for me is the people. I'm a people person. Not a people pleaser necessarily, but a people person.
And to keep the flow of new clients knocking on Jojo's sales door, she has work to do. Time to get some snaps for those all-important adverts.
I'm just going to go in and video and take some photographs so that I can get it up for sale as soon as possible.
And to sell the static home quickly, it's got to look spotless.
Just make sure that it looks as good as it can look. This basically gives them a better way of selling.
You can spend up to €70,000 on a second-hand caravan in these parts, but the more thrifty can always back a bargain.
Last week, I sold a home here for well under the asking price because it needs gutting out and everything. This is mid-range and it's very nice. It's got leather sofas, it's got a nice corner where you can look out to the sea. Everything you see here, it comes with. So it's not hard to sell. I'm just making it as big as possible.
Oh, hang on, I'm not ready. Cheese!
So that I get in the fact that they've got a beautiful dressing table.
Jojo is working her magic.
I'll put it through to the sales team. They'll give me a price. I'll put a for sale sign in the window and they can come and buy it.
That wallpaper's got to go. Now the caravan's ready to be listed for sale online. With those lovely photos, it's on to the next clients.
Just going to go and say hello to Joe and Steve. I need to sort out their sale. They want to sell this place because they're moving over the other side of the park.
And ambitious Jojo has a plan in mind.
I've got a viewing tomorrow. I don't muck about it. If you want it, the quick sale, I'm your girl.
It's 6 weeks into her new job and Jojo's showing no signs of slacking.
If I can get more for it, obviously I'm going to put it up for more and then we'll let them knock us down.
Yeah.
But as long as you end up with what you want to get out of it,
yeah, cool.
I'm happy with that.
Yeah.
All good to go then?
Yeah, all good to go.
Some really good shots in here. Oh, nice size bathroom. Perfect. I can get around the 30,000. So we'll put it up and see whether we get any offers. Fingers crossed we'll have a sale next week.
We'll be back to find out. While Jojo's working her socks off selling over on the Costa Blanca, there's a couple of Brits who are having a rare day off.
Hello! Nice to see you. Welcome to Sparkle Towers. Oh, look, Steve, we've got... Oh, how lovely to see you.
Lovely to see you too. Married couple Will and Steve were both born in Newcastle and moved to Spain 21 years ago.
This is, of course, where I do all my home cooking because I'm a marvellous...
All your home cooking?
Well, oh. Steve's the cook. I boil the kettle. Oh, so our kitchen with, of course, as would be expected, all the appliances. And then, of course, we'll take you to our living quarters. We spend most of our time outside with the adjoining balcony. We've got beautiful grounds. We've got tennis courts, Olympic class size swimming pool, 24-hour concierge, should we need him.
They're definitely all set up in their delightful home. And to make ends meet, like many other expats, they both have two jobs.
By daytime, by tour guides, taking holidaymakers out and about, and by nighttime, it's nighttime showtime, female impersonator work, and Steve is compere for my shows at nighttime. My stage name is Will Sparkle, because I will sparkle.
And mine is Steve Glimmer. So you've got Sparkling Glimmer.
Wasn't that a detective show in the 90s?
And this, of course, is the master bedroom. And we have separate wardrobes. My wardrobe's here, Steve's is in the other room.
This is my domain. Yes, of course, I do allow Sparkle to come in, but I spend a lot of time here because I do a lot of things behind the scenes for the shows and, of course, for the other work as well, for Vendôme Holiday. And what do they call it, these, when they've got these outside, now the men go out and drink all day, the man caves and whatnot, isn't it? But I suppose this is a bit of a gay cave, really.
Well, lovely, Steve. And these lovebirds go back nearly 50 years.
So we met in 1976. We were young boys, young lads.
That's the first ever photograph.
The first ever photograph, 1976.
Before moving to Spain, they called Wassenaar in South Holland home for 13 years.
I haven't looked at this for 20 years.
And in South Holland history, the couple are a pair of pioneers.
I was sitting at home and a phone call came through, and it was the local magistrate from the town hall, and she said, oh, this was about November, oh, the law's changed in Holland.
In 1998, the pair became civil partners, the same year that Holland first legally recognised same-sex civil partnerships.
The wedding was on the 5th of March, 1998, and you're getting married in 6 weeks' time.
She said, have you got any preferences? Well, I've got a preference. I prefer to have a female conduct the ceremony. And she had a grin on her face and she said, well, I'm a female.
People came from America, England, Spain, to Honda, and we got it all arranged within 6 weeks, and we had about 60 guests.
And 24 years after getting hitched, Will and Steve are still going strong and still keen to try new things.
I do have lots of clothes, gowns for the evening shows. I have them in various places. I've probably got about 60 gowns. Obviously, there's not enough room in the house.
So tonight, on their rare evening off, it's date night, and they're getting ready to go dancing.
Will, Sparkle, time's getting on. We know we've got to decide what you're wearing tonight for the rumba classes, salsa classes. I'm looking forward to seeing something different.
Having a spin round the room. I'm looking forward to it. I've never done salsa before.
Deep in rural Murcia, Colin Coco Brown's in a thoughtful mood while mucking out.
Sir Charles's been a little bit lonely, I think. He's had a little pony, but I think she's a little bit of a madam sometimes, so he doesn't like her too much.
East Lothian expat Colin is well known for his love of all animals, but you never forget your first, and for Colin, that all started with Chatto.
He started the charity, actually. He was the very first horse that we rescued. He was tied to a tree just outside Benidorm. So he stays here, but he's been with me for the past 4.5 years. He'll spend his rest of his days out here.
Good boy.
Since 2018, when Colin and partner Sebastian set up the charity, they've rescued and rehomed 51 horses, ponies and donkeys. And they've just sent 4 more off to forever homes in the UK.
It's constantly this is what happens. You send a few to the UK and then next game day, well, actually, I've managed to go 2 weeks without it. But then there's always ones needing help.
And true enough, just when you save four animals, another one turns up needing help.
I've had someone contact us to ask if we can help out with a horse. Now, he's been abandoned, but in a sense, it's not been abandoned in the street. It's actually been abandoned by its owner, so it's been left at a stables.
Nothing springs 39-year-old Colin into action more than a horse in need.
Not got any grazing or paddocks, so he's basically been in his box. It's like 3 metres by 3 metres for as long as the horse has been there, basically.
It sounds like the horse needs help right now.
They sent a few videos on being ridden, but that was quite a few years ago, so I don't know what condition he's going to be in.
Colin feels if he doesn't step in, the outcome could be fatal.
Been abandoned at the stables, and then the owner of the stables feels that it's not his responsibility either to get the horse seen to. Your option for him is just basically to have the horse put to sleep because it's not his horse.
But there's huge financial risk.
It is hard because it could rack up thousands and thousands of pounds worth of debt. We can only take 9 horses on our licence, so we've got to continually rehome, because once I take 9, I have to say no to people.
So the decision is a big one, but Colin doesn't hesitate.
Now that I know about the horse, I'm going to do something about it. Mainly, you've got to basically just think about the horse and what the horse's need is, not about money, really.
Colin has 4 spaces at the moment, and there's no question that one of them will now be reserved for the soon-to-be-rescued horse.
I just don't know what to expect when I go and look at this horse, basically. I'll see you when I come back. I'm going to put this on because you always open up your gate, don't you?
So today, Colin's on a rescue mission to Benidorm.
All secure, let's get going.
Who knows what he'll find when he gets there?
To maybe or maybe not collect a horse.
Coming up, Lee hopes the soggy bottom hasn't fallen out of the bread market.
But some days you're busy and some days you're not.
And married couple Will and Steve get ready to boogie.
No. OK, come on, let's go.
Let's get on.
With those beautiful beaches and laid-back way of life, those Spanish shores can sometimes feel a million miles away from home.
I think Spain is the perfect place to escape the UK because it's just so chilled.
Exactly, Jess.
In the UK, I'd get different looks to if I was to wear this down the high street, you know, if I was going shopping with the missus, for example.
Don't listen to them. That hat works anywhere, Dave.
It's like paradise in the sun.
You can have a nap halfway through the day and it's acceptable as well.
We don't follow time. We just get up when we get up. We go to bed when we're tired. We eat when we're hungry.
Hasta la vista, holidaymakers. And as many as 400,000 of us Brits love the lifestyle so much, we live here permanently. Just like Ian Buckley.
Good afternoon. My name is Ian. And I would like to show you my new home.
Oh, lovely, Ian.
This is my front room.
He said adios, Oldham, just 5 short weeks ago, and hola to this mobile home in Huelva.
Got my lovely telly from England there behind you. It's a 55-inch, so I can watch the football. This is a sofa bed. I've got my dining area here. This is my kitchen area. I do a lot of cooking myself. I've had to do that over the years since my partner died. At the moment, I just eat so much. I've got a fridge freezer here, storage cupboard. I retired last year, end of August. And in so many words, I thought, what do I do?
And 67-year-old Ian took a leap of faith and moved to Spain.
I've got all my knickknacks and everything. What I need, and there's another toilet here.
You can never have enough, Ian. He's not on his own in this caravan. He shares it with his special lady, Matilda the dog.
At the moment, it's just me and Matilda, but I have got room for it in the future if any of my friends or guests want to come down. This is my bedroom. It's a king-size bed. With the weather and everything, it's really, really warm. So I'm sleeping on top of the bed at the moment.
Well, you can't do that in Oldham.
And I thought, instead of rattling about in a lovely bungalow, me and my dog, I'll just move to Spain.
Ian chose his caravan on this site for more reasons than one.
So I wanted something quiet thingy, and I looked at it. There's a national park on here, loads of walks, and the place seemed very nice.
Perfect for a brand new life for you and Matilda, Ian.
And the weather, you can't beat the weather. Rainy UK, and it's sunshining all the time here.
All right, don't rub it in. See you, Ian.
Hey.
Like most of the Sundays today on the Costa del Sol finds baker Lee Baldwin on his stall at the Lemon Tree Market in Guadamar del Segura.
So inside here is like, this is like the Aladdin's cave.
Right, now we can unload.
Bread, cake, pies, Lee's got the lot. He's only 7 weeks into his new venture at the market. He's debuting his poppy seed bread here and is hoping to sell every last crumb.
Half nine, it picks up, but the last couple of weeks it's been sporadic. I reckon about 10 o'clock it really peaks, doesn't it? You go, boom. You have to be prepared.
Poised and ready, Lee, here's your first potential customer. Yeah.
What can I get, Governor?
Four poppy.
Four poppy, eh? Four. You like them?
I do.
Nice?
Yes, very good. Nice.
Ooh, the poppy seed is making a strong start.
Two steak kidney, yeah.
All done?
Yeah, that's
8.8. Thank you very
much. My bread comes from England, and they flock to it, the English, because when they go on holiday, what do they want to do? They would move their whole house here for the holiday, if they could.
So there's your loyalty card.
Lovely. Yes. Thank you very much.
Every €5 you spend in the shop, I give you a stamp.
By introducing a loyalty card with freebies, he hopes it will keep folks coming back for more.
After 10 stamps, you get a free bag of donuts.
Did someone say donuts?
So the idea is it captures more people to come back, encourages it.
Can I have a chicken and mushrooms?
Yeah, five, please. Sure.
His stall seems to be attracting the locals.
Our apartment is quite close to where his actual shop is, so we're quite surprised to see him here today.
Lovely, thank you very much.
All right, no worries.
We'll see you in the shop.
Yeah, see you later. A halfway of what we would want for sales. We've done around about €160 already. Over the last 7 weeks, it's been up and down. This Sunday, it was very slow, and I think the heat had a big part to do with it, but it then picked up later on. That's €9, sir. Thank you very much. The spondoolies are flying. A new line, blown out. Poppy rolls, 25 I've sold. The bloomers, we've sold 5. That ain't bad. The market's definitely the way forward for the business, definitely. And if I don't sell this, I'll sell it down the shop. I'll go back to Corsada or open the shop up. And usually what happens, everybody flocks and buys it. So I'm not going to lose out either way. I would like to take a break, but there's no break this year. There's no break next year because we're still building the business. But some days you're busy and some days you're not. Like always, you can't predict it, you know?
Today might have been a little slower than Lee expected, but it isn't all about high profits and being rushed off your feet. You can't put a price on job satisfaction, eh, Lee?
And I look above the door and I think, I've still got my name up on the door, you know, and I've done it. I've achieved something. No matter what happens the next day, I know I've achieved what I wanted to do. So every day is like a good day.
You are today's star baker for sure, Lee.
There we are, sir. Thank you very much. Have a good day, yeah?
After a busy morning putting two caravans up for sale on the Costa del Sol, sales fanatic Jojo's now off to meet a potential client who's looking to purchase a new one.
Hiya, Jerry, how are you doing?
Not too bad, Jojo, nice to see you again.
Ready for a bit more park life.
Well, with a pool like that, you can't go wrong.
I know. Well, I've got a really nice van for you to look at today. It's called a Louisiana.
Yeah, come on, let's have a look.
Yeah, come on. You can open both doors up really wide. So this is the main living area. It's all open plan. This pulls out to a double bed. You've got your fridge freezer over there. Take a seat, Jerry, so see how you feel about the place. I mean, the nice thing about it is you can stick your telly up on the wall up there.
Yeah.
You can just relax, but it's outdoor living as well.
Yeah, you're outside more than we're in.
What more do you want out of life?
Not a lot.
No.
What about the essentials?
Oh, nice size bed. Good storage. That's perfectly big enough for me. Full hob and oven. A lot of them don't have it. They don't have an oven. I don't know how they cook roast chickens myself. Yeah, plenty of storage. Extractor. Nice size.
Walk in.
Perfect. Don't need anything more than that. They'll be out on the decking.
Jerry seems keen, but is he buying?
What's your first impression? Did you want, like, smaller, bigger?
I probably want something a little bit bigger, to be honest.
Right, well, we've got two coming up round the corner and we could go and have a quick look.
Yeah, that'd be all right.
Because I've got a feeling that's a three-bedroom. Maybe that would be the one for you.
Jojo's always got her eyes on the prize. And if Jerry's game, she may well still get a sale today. Over in Benidorm, fun-loving couple Steve and Will are getting ready for a night out in the town they've called home for 21 years.
Benidorm's a fabulous place. It's got some... We can have a good standard of living here. We do work hard. We both still work hard. We have several jobs. You're in the sunshine 10, 11 months of the year.
And the well-travelled husbands are always up for new adventures.
Oh, we used to go to the Eurovision Song. We used to go to the Eurovision Song Festival most years, Stockholm, Copenhagen.
So they do our show, isn't it? That's one of my lines in the show, the Gay Man's World Cup.
Today, they're off to see what Benidorm has to offer on a rare night off work and have booked him for salsa lessons.
When we were talking about dancing, I said to Steve, why don't we try a salsa class? We've never done salsa.
Now, I am a little bit weary, but, looking forward to it.
No, not nervous. I'm just excited about it.
Will, also known as Sparkle in his work as a female impersonator, is used to strutting his stuff.
I love entertaining. I call this one my Cadbury's fake dress. It's a beautiful dress, but I have about 30 or 40 different ones. But this is, I change them. I can use this for when I'm doing Shirley Bassey.
The gowns are having a night off, but even on a night off, Will Sparkle still likes to live up to his name.
Call it my night going out dancing. Wardrobes. Steve takes minutes to decide what to wear. And tonight is salsa. Oh, that's a nice one for salsa. Maybe that one.
Hey, we're ready for action.
Ready for salsa.
Very smart boys.
Oh, these are wonderful dancing shoes, these. Patent leather. Patent leather dancing shoes. On the charity shop, so I can't complain. I'm very, very comfy.
Mine isn't a charity shop, I must admit. And look, my Christmas present off Steve. I've got some lovely shoes, which I thought I'd put on for the first time tonight for our salsa pack.
You're all set to get them snake hips shimmying, lads.
OK then, Steve. Better get off, because our salsa teacher's waiting for us.
Fräulein will be waiting.
And we don't want you to delay the salsa teacher.
You don't. Chop, chop.
OK, come on, let's go.
Let's get off.
At a stables on the outskirts of Benidorm, Colin Coco Brown has just arrived after a two-hour mercy dash to meet a horse called Naggy, who's been abandoned.
Let's go see the horse.
Hello, mister.
Do you want me to etch something for you? Do you want me to etch that for you? Is that what it is? He's trying to tell me something. Me, the horse whisperer. But I think he's just basically showing me by his mouth that he wants me to etch something.
Naggy was abandoned by his owner, and the stable that has kindly been looking after him can no longer afford to do so.
Because the stallion has just been kept on his own, so he's not been able to socialise with any other horses, and horses are sociable animals. They need that kind of connection with other horses. I've only known him for 5 minutes, and he doesn't even care that I'm here. He just tells a nice nature.
The stable owner seems to have done all they can to help the abandoned horse.
He's had the veterinarian over to do the injections to try and help him out, because 7 days ago he couldn't even eat.
Naggy has medical needs too.
You have a wee bit of breathing problem, yeah. Need to get it unblocked. Thing is, if I don't take the horse that the stable owner's got no other option for him. Basically, there's not really going to be many people that would come in and take horses for now, not rideable, needs operations done. The saddest thing is the cheapest option would be just to have him put to sleep.
He's only 18, and horses can live for at least another 10 years, given the right care. Colin has a big decision to make.
You're a good boy, yeah. You're not bothered about nothing.
Like, honestly, see, in the UK as well, like, some people would pay thousands and thousands of thousands for a horse like this.
But it could take thousands to get him fit and healthy, though. But Colin's big decision, it turns out, doesn't seem so big.
Oh, you're so sweet. You can tell already. Look what I brought, just in case. I had Colin and Lidro.
Phew, Nagy's going home with Colin.
I think Sebastian knows when I'm taking the trailer somewhere, he knows that I'm coming up with something. Uh-oh, doesn't fit. We're just a little bit nervous because he's been here for quite some time. We're not going to show how it's going to go in the trailer, so we shall see. So the guy at the stables here is really, really fortunate that I've actually got a space at the rescue centre for him to take this horse on.
This could be Nagy's new chance in life. If he'll go into the trailer, that is.
Good boy. He spent quite a few years here, so we're just giving him his time, his space. Good boy. Here we go. Slowly but surely, all the way back to Murcia. He goes home, fam. Here we come.
2 hours later, Nagy has arrived at his new home. And for the first time in a long time, Nagy can enjoy the fresh air outside and begin a brighter future with Colin and his growing menagerie. Coming up, Wheeler dealer Jojo Love is hoping for success.
I think we've got Sal. I can smell it.
And aspiring dancers Will and Steve put their best foot forward.
What we've learned so far is excellent.
It's the end of the day at the caravan park, and Jojo's hoping she's found client Jerry his perfect portable home.
So that one down there, they show the kids, they've got an animation team in, and behind it you've got like an assault course. And over here you've got shower blocks, a sauna.
Former insurance broker Jerry Ball from Bath used to own a static in Spain, but for the past couple of years he's been renting an apartment in Molina. Now Caravan Life is calling to him once again.
And it's a really well-maintained site, this.
He was keen on the first caravan he saw, but it wasn't quite big enough.
We're going to go and see a man called John. He's this one over here. Hiya, John. Thank you. Right, do you want to show us around?
Yeah, sure. Okay, come on in.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, so it's a central living area. So you've got the kitchen and the bedrooms off. We've got one bedroom off this side, and you've got the two bedrooms off that side.
Oh, so it's a three bed?
Yes, it's a three bed.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Just what Jerry's after.
You wanted a bigger one than what you've just seen,
yeah,
didn't you?
A little bit bigger. This is
so this is really nice.
Jerry's keen to find a new park home, but this is far from a done deal yet.
Take a look around. I won't be nosy yet. I'm going to take pictures and get it up for sale, hopefully, eh?
Yes, yeah.
If Jerry doesn't have it, someone will.
Separate loo again, excellent.
Ah, the small things.
That's good size as well.
You said that last time, Jerry.
That's mainly for guests. Unless if I come over here with a pool like that, I think I'll get a few more.
Don't forget to show him the outdoor living space, Jojo.
Oh, Jerry, look at that barbecue. Sit out here, looking at pine forest. The dog can go bark, bark, I want to walk. And you've got a nice parking space with this. I think you'd be lucky to get this one.
Jojo's not giving up.
Are you interested in this van, Jerry?
Yes.
You are. I think the best thing to do is for me and John to have a conversation. And then I can come back to you and give you a price. And
give me a base price and we can go from there.
Yeah, we can go from there.
Yeah.
Is that okay with you, Jerry?
Yeah, that works for me.
Brilliant.
Fingers crossed.
Thank you very much, John.
Yeah,
nice to meet you. Thank you. Bye. I'm not a hard salesperson, but I'm a good salesperson. What I'll do, I'll talk to John in the morning and I'll get back to you by the afternoon.
Yeah.
And maybe we can do a deal. But thanks for coming.
No problem.
Ever the optimist, Jojo is convinced it's a deal.
I'll make the phone calls tomorrow, the necessary phone calls. Give him a price. I think we've got a sale. I can smell it. Great.
Jerry later decided the caravan wasn't the one for him, but Jojo did find a buyer for Joe and Steve's caravan. You win some, you lose some. Overall, good going, Jojo. Over in Benidorm...
Come on, we'll miss our lesson, come on.
Twinkle-toed couple Steve and Will have arrived at their private salsa dance class. With professional dancers Domi and Juani, who are ready and waiting.
Hola.
Encantado.
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 Hola. I think it's important you get out there and try and enjoy.
But you have danced before? No.
I dance always, but never salsa.
Good.
Not first time.
Very good.
We have to live our lives in the daytime. We have to do the jobs. But when the sun goes down, that is when I feel at home.
Inside out, we have 8 times and 6 steps. Let's dance.
The sociable pair are always up for new experiences.
I just love the lights, the music.
I just don't want to sit in the bar drinking.
Well, you've come to the right place, Will.
I can't sit still.
How's your hips?
My hips are fine.
Okay.
I love dancing, love movement. Obviously, at 62, I don't do what I did when I was 42, but I do enjoy dancing.
So take it away, Will and Steve.
Oh.
Now, this is better where you can just do your own thing. Well, very interesting. I mean, I don't think I'll be entering any competitions, but it's interesting to learn the steps.
Am I natural? No. But I'm trying.
That's all that matters, Will. Ooh, and they're really getting into it now. All warmed up, chaps.
They make it look easy, but very much more difficult. People see salsa and they think it's really easy.
But I'm more of a freestyle salsa.
We're still able to enjoy life, and we're still young in Benidorm. I think at 64, you're still young. We've learned so far is excellent. I think I might be back next week.
It's a 10 from me, lads. Keep dancing. Next time on the Costas, Sass is trying to give diners perfect fries to help Darren's bar business.
He's put them in that fryer.
And Frank is fundraising by hacking away at his pride and glory.